I'm Jim Aho from Marquette State Fish Hatchery. I'm a biologist here. Came here in 2003 as a biologist and has worked since then. Our rearing assignments were going down a little bit, and lake trout are on and the Great Lakes are on a natural reproduction schedule. So and we were reduced in our lake trout population here at the hatchery, so we didn't have to rear as many lake trout to release into the Great Lakes. And so we took that water and ran it through our broodstock area, and then we could raise grayling broodstock. But they were mainly in the northern lower peninsula from, say, Bay City north to the bridge. The process was we had to go to Alaska in May of 2019. We got the first broodstock as eggs, and we brought those eggs back. They went into isolation for 2 years. In September 2020, we brought those fish as young adults here in Michigan to Marquette Hatchery, and we have them inside so far on well water, and there's 4,000 individuals in that lot. So the first group should mature this spring coming up here, and then the consecutive groups will mature 3 to 4 years after that. So it's going to be 6 years, 7 years to before we see the first group of eggs where we're going to take off that broodstock and we can introduce those into the streams. Other states have looked at releasing sub-adults or yearlings, and they seem to not imprint and find a way back to where they're native, where they were stocked. So they need that imprinting at a very young age, we believe. Other fish do that, like sturgeon, do that imprint at a very young age and then drift down, and then to find their way back. So we're trying to match what the fish needs. Might be a long time, but I think it's gonna be worth the wait.